The Houston Astros have dominated Major League Baseball for the past couple of years, but this wasn't always the case. How did the 2013 Disastros go from recording their worst record in the organization's history to World Series champions in only 4 years? And they're currently competing for another one? The secret is in a little something called data-driven baseball. But before we jump into this, welcome back to another video, guys. If you're new here and you're a coach, player, or trainer interested in learning more about the practical applications of data-driven baseball, you've come to the right place. Join the movement now by clicking the subscribe button down below for more weekly baseball animations. The Astros have built up a dynasty, like that of the New England Patriots or Golden State Warriors in years past, which is incredibly difficult to do in this sport compared to others. And they're not just doing it at the big league level. They're also seeing serious success developing athletes in the minors as well. And all of this seemed to occur overnight. So this begs me to ask a question. How did they do it? The rise of this empire was documented in a phenomenal book called Astroball, The New Way to Win It All by Ben Reiter. This is a personal favorite book of mine, and if you haven't read it yet, you must. It goes into great depth on the process of building up this culture in a fun and easy to read way. It talks about the stories of the masterminds behind it all, and Jeff Luneau and Sig Meidel. It touches on how data played a part in this rebuild, several great behind-the-scenes looks at individual player acquisitions. Verlander's story is my personal favorite. Their ability to stick to the processes that they created, and the difference it made for them in their success, and then just the story of them winning it all, an inside look in the clubhouse and the upper management's role in all of this. Again, it's a phenomenal read, so go check it out. In particular, we're going to focus on the second bullet point in today's video. However, not exactly the way you may think. The Astros' secret wasn't the same as the story in Moneyball, where one statistic opened the eyes of an organization and changed the game the way it was played. It was their ability to utilize what has been going on for years in this game by trusting the gut and adding it in with this new technology. This idea wasn't old school versus new school. It was more of a man plus the machine story. The story tells the tale of two very different individuals, Sig and Jeff, and their paths to the Astros. They go into great depth of each of their pasts and what it took to get them there after meeting with the Cardinals, which I won't go into great depth here, but I think it's important to touch on a little bit. Prior to becoming the director of operations and general manager of the Astros, Jeff Luneau spent 8 years working in baseball as a scout for the Cardinals. He was the guts of this operation, but he was no stranger to data. His way of thinking was also inspired by the Moneyball era, but his experience in the game helped him get a feel for proper decision making. Sig, on the other hand, had a very different experience. After completing college, Sig went out to work as a rocket scientist for NASA. Yeah, that NASA. His role with the Astros and the Cardinals was to create a system to help analyze and develop players they were acquiring and moving on. His role with the Astros was the director of decision sciences. He's since moved on to work as the assistant general manager of analytics for the Orioles, and he's doing some phenomenal stuff there. With the Astros, he created what they refer to in the book as the nerd cave. This idea of old school versus new school isn't the way to go. The gut feeling versus the cold hard data. And that's what the Astros did so differently. The old school approach on scouting wasn't wrong. It just needed improvements. So that's what the Astros did. They found ways to quantify and weigh everyone's decision-making process compared to how they rank athletes on average to give a better idea of their true potential. The Astros realized that no computer can determine the human aspect of the game to see how a kid's makeup is, how hard they work, how they are with the team and in the clubhouse. Those are intangibles that actually do matter at the end of the day. And lastly, they look for people with the growth mindset. This is a very interesting topic that can be applied anywhere in life, so definitely check out this book if you're interested in reading more on this. Then they paired this with a new wave of data analysis. Data that had already been accumulated, so how could the organization use this information to make better informed decisions? It was used heavily for player acquisitions and to gauge how each player was doing at their current level. Sig even created a score to show if an athlete needed to be promoted or demoted based on several quantifiable factors of their play. The whole idea here was that Sig and Jeff were creating systems to be followed strictly. There are very few exceptions. It was like a game of blackjack. If you have a 16 and the dealer is showing a 7, you always hit. You trust the data to back up the decisions you're making, and you know that you may bust sometimes. and this was a brilliant piece about this whole idea. It paired the best of these worlds to create a fully functioning system to analyze players, and it made making some of these tough decisions even easier. It wasn't man versus machine or old school versus new school, it was both. So what does this mean for baseball, for you and me? Well, the Astros went from losing 2/3 of their games over a 3-year period to almost completely reversing it in just a matter of 3 seasons. This idea stemmed from utilizing this data for the greater good, in harmony with the other old school practices to create a powerhouse ball club. It gave them a system to follow, like a train on the rails. You follow your plan no matter what is going on ahead of you. You follow those rails and you keep moving forward. The data gave them a point to hit, or stand. Then they could use their guts off that, but at least they had a system in place to start making their decisions. But the rest of Major League Baseball is beginning to figure this out, slowly but surely. Employers are beginning to look for people with this skill set, to be able to understand, interpret, and apply data in the real world. So that's exciting news for you and I. Keep adding to that toolbox, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. If you liked today's video or you just want to support the channel, please leave a like down below. Leave a comment with any questions or suggestions for a future video, and subscribe for more weekly baseball animations posted every Wednesday.